This is Heavy Conversation with Bruce and Jody, a podcast where we talk about being a big guy in today's world.
I'm Bruce.
And I'm Jody. Here we go.
Hello, Bruce.
Jody, hello.
How's it going?
It's good. It's good. I'm feeling good. It's a beautiful day. There's no rain. I'm feeling good about life today.
I know. I'm totally winning today. I got up before 9 a.m.
Hey.
So I'm hashtag winning. That's all I have to say.
Nice. Very nice. Yeah, I felt really productive today. Like, you know, earlier this week, I didn't really feel it. I just wasn't there. You know, I just didn't feel like, I don't know if it's everything that's going on and being stuck inside or what, but I just wasn't feeling it. But today, it came back around. I've gotten a lot done. I feel productive. I feel like it's going to be okay.
Yeah, it has been a good day for me so far. So I'm looking forward to the rest of it. So today we're going to talk about the ever elusive or not so elusive body hair.
Ooh, body hair. Yes.
So yeah, I mean, we're both beard guys. We have beards, you know, and guys have a lot of issues either with their beards or their hair, but there's hair everywhere else on your back, on your chest, on your legs, mm-hmm. but it everywhere. For some Indeed. Of us, I have hair everywhere. So
yes.
We're going to kind of talk about some of the tips or tricks or advice or whatever on either removal or maintenance or whatnot on your body hair.
We're going to talk all things body hair.
Yay.
I love it.
So yes. Buckle up.
Yes. So let's start high level here. Let's start body hair. Love it. Hate it. Do you feel like it needs to be well managed? Like where do you stand? Are you pro or against body hair? What do you think?
I mean, I like body hair. So, mm-hmm. and I'm hairy, but most of my body hair is like blonde, like on my arms and stuff. Mm. You can't really see it.
Right.
So it's not like my beard where it's really dark or anything. So my body hair I'm fine with, cause it's my body. I'm like, whatever. I'm not too concerned about trimming or anything. It's a good length. It's not anything crazy. So
sure.
Yeah. I think as long as it's maintained, you know, either trimmed if it needs to. I don't necessarily like it if you go through all the work of trimming or shaving or whatevering, everything. That just seems like a lot of work for me. That's why I grew a beard in the first place, so I don't have to shave every day.
Right, right. Yeah. Well,
what about you?
For me, I don't mind the body hair. I like to trim, sculpt it, you know. Mm-hmm. Just kind of keep it under control a little more. I think for me, that's just, you know, I don't know. I just prefer it like that. Now, that said, there are certainly times where I just let it all go au naturel. Yep. But, you know, for me, I think I feel best when I kind of manage it, you know. So that's kind of where I'm at.
Yeah.
And I mean, as far as like my hairiness level, I don't think that I'm not overly hairy. I'm not like a Sasquatch.
I was going to say Sasquatch. Yeah, there's like Sasquatch. Right. I don't know what would be under that.
Right.
Bear. I don't know.
Yeah, right, right. I'm not like super, super hairy, but I, you know, got enough hair. And I think that it's, you know, it's not anything out of the ordinary, really. So,
yeah.
You know, so I feel pretty good about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I said, I'm fine. I mean, I've never been self-conscious about my body hair or anything because, like I said, it's so light-colored. People sometimes comment on that. They're like, I didn't realize that you had arm hair until you got up close. Because it's so, especially right. in the summertime, it's like golden. Mm. Like my eyebrows and my hair on my head will get really light in the summertime too. So
right. I mean, yeah, it's
the ginger thing.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, generally, you know, a little bit, yeah, not
you can see a little bit on your arm there, but
yeah, but not too much. And I, you know, I think, when I was younger, I definitely like, I got some hair on my back, but I mean, again, it's not anything. I've seen some hairy backs and this is, there's nothing to write home about. It's not, it's not at that level. And but I, when I was younger, those kind of things were more concerning to me. Hair, you know, hair in places that I didn't necessarily want it. So I worked pretty hard to try and take care of that.
Yeah.
For a long time now, you know, I'm good with it, and I don't feel like I need to be doing anything generally.
Okay. So what did you do to manage your back hair or hair in the places you didn't want it?
So
like the hardest place to maintain it.
Totally. Because, you know, if you're trying to use a razor and trying to get back there, you're, you know, yeah, it's not fun. Yeah.
Yeah. I do like, I notice like my shoulder, like the tops of my shoulders or whatever, like the top of my back, there's longer hair there. Sometimes I'm like, what is going on?
But, right.
You know, yeah, I don't really worry about it.
It's always been me just kind of trying to shave it, you know, with like a razor or whatever, which I'm not taking my time to do that. I'm not doing the stretches that are needed to prepare to get your arm back behind your head and, you know, try and take care of that. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. And
so you shaved it like with a,
I did for a while. Yeah. I would shave it down. And I mean, you know that when you're trying to do that, you're not doing a great job because you're trying to do it yourself. So it's like, what, you know, I really would end up doing most of my shoulders and, you know, and my upper arms. And I did my upper arms because I've got tattoos on both arms. And so I just felt like, I didn't like the idea of my tattoos having hair coming out of them.
Yeah.
And so I'm still kind of there with that. So, you know, from time to time, if it bothers me, then I'll shave that. But, you know, I mean, it's been cold, so it's not like I've been showing off the guns or anything like that, you know? So
it's getting there though. It's getting
it is
pool season and shirtless season. So,
yep.
But yeah, I've never done any like major shaving of any of my body hair. I just, the only places I like have to maintain are like my head. Like
right.
I get crazy ear hair and like eyebrows. Like that's where the hair comes in for me. I don't know.
Let's talk eyebrows.
Old man eyebrows. I'm like, where did that come from?
Yes. I've on this, my right eyebrow, I've got like one hair that is just this wiry old white hair that just comes out and goes straight up. And I know that in like 15 years, both of them are just going to be like, I'm going to look like a movie villain or something. It's going to be amazing.
Those but crazy, I mean, caterpillars on your, right there.
Totally. And you've got to pull them. I mean, I can't just have the one because it feels weird. So, you know, I know it's there and I can't leave it alone.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, but other than that, I mean, as far as like white hairs and all that, I'm good with that kind of stuff. It's just like, yeah, exactly. I know.
It's weird because I have a patch right here on my chin.
Mm-hmm.
But when it gets long is when I start really noticing it, when my beard gets long. So when I trim it down, it doesn't seem quite as noticeable. So got to keep it short and then have that weird white patch there.
I used to grow my beard pretty long. You know, I used to let it get long and just kind of unruly. But now I'm really finding that I prefer it not super short, but, you know, about this length, but, you know, more cleaned up. It's not super long.
I use this Wall. It's a Wall brand trimmer.
Nice.
And it has like a bunch of different guards, like little things that you put on there. I use that for my beard, trim it down, keep it nice and neat. But I also recently, since we've been quarantined up for however long now, I don't know. But I used it to like do the sides of my head. I went for days. I'm like, okay, I'm going to do it. No, I'm not going to do it. Okay, I'm going to do it, but I'm not going to do very much.
Nice.
So I did like one that was really long and kind of did a little bit. And I was like, okay, that's not enough.
that's the way to do it.
That's my one tip. You start slow, you know, don't just shave it off, you know, use a trimmer.
Right.
With a guard and go slow and take off. Because you can always take off a little bit more if you need to. You can't
put it back on. No.
Can't go back. So I thought I did an okay job. You know, there's kind of a line, but it's not too bad.
Listen, you're not a professional. So if you're able to do it without giving yourself like a side reverse mohawk, then I feel like you've succeeded.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
that's my one big tip is go slow, take off a little bit. You know, you can always go a little bit further, a little bit more when you're trimming.
Right.
Whatever you're trimming, you can go a little bit more. So
definitely. So for me, I am lucky in that I married a hairstylist, and so she's able to cut my hair and trim my beard and do that kind of thing. And she does it. She doesn't love doing men's hair because it's not really what her thing. But you know, in the time that we've been together, she's you know, she does mine. And so you know, it's been good to kind of have that. And she's learned, you know, how to do my hair and make it work. And
if she's done it a couple times, she'll know how it works and what works for your hair.
And now she's been doing it for over a decade, so it's you know, she's got it down. I have a small trimmer called a peanut, and it's it's great for like under my beard line. You know, it'll start to grow out. I usually trim that. So I use that. I do my lip because my beard is, I've got a whaler is this type of beard. And, it is, it's what I go with. So the shaving that I do of my face is really just my upper lip and my beard line. And the peanut's pretty good for that. It's small. It's
a little trimmer.
It is. It's totally just a little trimmer that, it's a, you know, it's a wired trimmer. So you plug it in and go to town, and I love it. It's, I've had it for years, and it's been great.
Yeah.
But I did ask her for just some high level tips. You know, if one happens to be stuck at home during a pandemic and they want to cut their hair,
or if you can't get in to see your stylist, maybe just normally.
Or that, if you're feeling up to it and you want to try and do your own hair, she says, and I'm going to read this from the text because I did just text her for this. She says, if you're using shears, always cut into the hair vertically and not horizontally. It'll blend better, and you won't take as much off trying to make things even.
Mm-hmm.
She says, if using clippers, start with the longest guard, generally an 8, and work your way toward the shorter guards as you move up the head. As you move down the head, excuse me. So 8 up top, 2 on bottom.
Yeah.
Use 6 and 4 between the two lengths to blend. And she asked me if that makes sense. And yes, sure.
Yeah, that's what I did. I used a shorter one like on the bottom part and up above, like right about my ear. And then I used a little bit longer one a little higher up.
Yeah.
To blend it in. Yeah. Yay. Right.
Yeah. Yes. You got it. You got it. There we go. And thank you, Shauna, for the information here. So now if you're listening and you decide to try and cut your own hair, please send us pictures.
Yes. I want to see it
or bad. After.
Yeah.
Yes. Good. Yes. We want to see it all.
So I use for like shaving, I use this little electric razor.
Oh yeah. Nice.
It's like a Norelco, whatever. I got this for Christmas because the one I had before I had since high school. I had replaced the like the head, the blades a couple times, but they didn't even make the right blades for it anymore. So I got this new one for Christmas. It's like butter, like just cuts it so nice.
I love it.
Can you hear it?
Listen to that.
Yeah, that's my morning routine. Or I haven't in a while. I need to kind of do my neck and stuff. But
same.
I know, I think you had a review about this one blade thing.
Yes.
It's like fancy and a little leather.
So if you are a discerning shaver and you want to, you want a razor blade that you will probably keep for the rest of your life, one blade is worth looking at. So yes, this is one of them that, if you're watching the video, you can see Jody is holding the one
it's
blade,
like,
and
it's like got some weight to it. It's nice,
right? It feels substantial, but it's not like super heavy. It's easy to use.
But it's not like those thick razors that I feel like I'm gonna break or something.
Right. It's specifically made to. It's like a luxury razor, basically. Yeah.
I'm sort of intimidated by this thing. I've only done a couple times with like a regular razor, but my skin is super sensitive and I'll cut myself and I'll break out and I'll just get crazy razor burn. And
So my thing with that is that if you're gonna shave that way, you have to take the time and go through that entire process. And most mm-hmm. of us don't want to take that time.
Yeah.
You know, that's always the thing with me whenever I would shave that way, is that I wasn't willing to make sure
put the hot water on it and relax it and
use a hot towel, do the whole thing. Yeah. And most of the time I just don't want to spend the time doing that. So that wasn't for me, but I think that it is a good way to treat yourself, especially mm-hmm. if, you know, well, we're stuck at home, you know, be able to do that and give it a try. And they run the spectrum. One blade has a lot of different blades, and they are, this is not a $2 Bic. It's going to run you. And some of them, they get very expensive depending on.
There was like a solid gold one too, wasn't there?
Yeah. I feel like
a super crazy baller one.
Yeah. I feel like there was one that was up in the thousands. Now don't let that scare you away from looking at the site, because they do have more affordable options. And this is really, it is a product. It's not going to be a product for everybody, but it is a product for those people who want those kind of luxury things and are going to hold on to them for a long time. I want to say that they're maybe the one that you just showed us there. I want to say it might've been around $50.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm not sure. I don't remember.
Yeah. Yeah, but if you get it, you'll keep it for life. So
yeah, Bjorn loves using it, but he said it gets such a nice shave when he does it. But it's, again, it's like you have to take the little bit of extra time to do it. But
right, so it's not your everyday. You've got plenty of
time to do that now, so that's fine.
Yes,
but I'm a little lazier, and I just use the electric and just zip it around.
Same.
And do that, and that's what I do. But I do have did you have a thing?
Oh, it's beer time.
Oh, beer time. Okay. Sorry. What do you got?
It's beer time. All right. So I'm going to show you
beer. What do you got?
I don't know that the beer is as exciting as what I'm bringing the beer in.
Oh.
Which is this thing.
What is that thing?
So I got this thing. Bomber? I got this thing for Christmas, and it is supposed to keep your drinks cold. And so basically the way that it works is you can put bottles in it, you can put cans in it. It has a rubber top, so you could have your bottle stick out of here and you could drink from your bottle with this.
So it's like a cooler koozie thing.
It's like a modern cooler koozie thing, and it's got
trying to describe it. I'm like, what is
that? And it's got a bottle opener that's in the top that you can take out that I can't get back in, so we're not doing that. But then you can also unscrew the thing, and you can use it in different ways. So if you want to use it for, say, cans, then, which is what I am trying to do here. Okay. So yeah, so then your can actually goes in. Your can won't drop out, but you can drink from this, and you're good to go. So
nice.
It helps keep it cool. I didn't understand how this thing worked when I first opened it. So I actually poured the beer directly into it and was trying to drink from it. And Shauna stared at me for a little while and let me take a few drinks, spill it all over myself, and then was like, don't do that. So it's made by, I think it's Asobu, A-S-O-B-U. And so it's a good way to transport your beverages without having to take them out of the containers they're in and keep them cool.
Mm-hmm.
So today I am drinking Peaches for Me IPA.
Nice.
Yes, from Red Hook in Seattle.
Nice.
And it is a peachy IPA. Peach and mango.
Peachy for Me. That one sounds good.
Peaches for Me. Yeah. It's hoppy. Yeah. Yep. It's all about the IPA. It's a strong one. There's peach and mango at the end. I definitely get more peach than mango, but I'll take their word for it. So yes.
Peach for Me? I can't. P-E-A.
Peaches. Peaches.
For
mm-hmm. Peaches for Me. Yeah. There we go.
Nice.
All right. I'm going to try and drink out of this thing and see how this.
So it's a 6.7 ABV and a 50 IBU.
Yeah.
Nice. So make sure you're following along on our Untappd app. We have all our beers on there. So how, what do you think? You said it was kind of hoppy.
It's hoppy. It is, it's not super peachy, which I appreciate that. I would like a little more peach or a little more mango. But it's all right. I don't think I'd put it up at the top of my list, but I wouldn't put it at the bottom either.
Okay.
I like some of their other beers, so, you know, hey.
Nice. So I'm drinking Little Squeezy.
Hey.
Little Squeezy Juicy Ale, another Deschutes beer. I'm kind of a big fan. It's very popular around here. This is a 5% ABV and a 40 IBU. So this one's probably going to be kind of hoppy too.
Deschutes people, if you're listening, please send Jody some of your beer.
Yes, I'm drinking refreshingly juicy.
I like that. Yeah.
It is hoppy. That's good though.
Is it refreshingly juicy?
I think I need to try again.
Yes.
Yes, that's good.
Perfect.
It is hoppy though. It's like right on the line of I'm not sure. I haven't had a lot of hoppy beers in a while, so
nice.
No fruit was harmed in the making of this beer, by the way, so you know,
very important.
That's what it says.
So you know, we've kind of talked about trimmers and some of this, and you know that the question that will come up if we don't cover it is talking about trimming, shaving, and grooming down south. So
down south,
you know, down south.
Oh, like your nether, your private
nether area. Regions. Yep.
Your balls and stuff. Well,
trimming your personals.
I can say that I have and I do, and I've done a few different variations of that to try them. But again, go slow.
Right.
Use a guard if you're going to do anything. I use what they normally recommend is using a different trimmer if you're going to do like your body hair from your like your beard or your face. Have another trimmer for that, but whatever. I just use the big trimmer with a guard on it and keep it groomed up. I guess that's about all I do anymore.
Indeed. Yeah. I'm the same way. I mean, I want to keep it short, keep it clean, less hair. It's good to go. So that's always kind of where I'm headed. So, you know, I don't know if it's like a thing for just like you're a bigger guy, you get hot and it just feels better. I mean, maybe it's just a me thing. I just prefer having things a little more trimmed. So, you know, that's the way that I go. And yes, it is. It's always about being careful. You take your time. There's nothing like catching a nut in the trim.
Keep the like razors away. I don't know that's just a horrible idea. Go slow. Use like what I've heard is those, you know, those little bitty trimmers that you use for like ear hair and nose hairs
are
super little, and they don't even really have like a blade on it. I've heard that you can use that to trim like your ball hair and stuff.
I guess if you're trying to get details, if you're trying to get like the crevices and the specific angles, I guess
you have to pull the skin taut so that it doesn't get caught in there. That gets scary. I've only done that like extreme shaving like once, and I'll never do it again. It was a lot of work, and I didn't like it. It was uncomfortable. I'm like, no.
It's much like auto detailing. You need the right tools to be able to do what you're trying to do.
Or maybe you need to get someone else to do it. I don't know, because there's a lot of – you can get a professional to go in there and take care of all that stuff.
I am curious about, like, waxing, you know, and how – what that process is like. So I had my legs waxed for something – when I was in radio. It's coming back to me. It's been a very long time.
Yeah, you need to wax your legs for radio. Definitely.
Yeah, most of the time that massive amounts of body hair have left my body has been because I was in radio. And there's another story I want to tell about that. But this one, just with waxing, is that I do remember that I had my legs waxed for some. There was some ad promotion radio thing that was going on, and they at one of those like a beauty school, and so they wanted to have somebody do the waxing on my legs, and I can't remember if it was painful or what. I just remember sitting in the chair.
The only thing I've ever done is I like wax the hair on the top of my foot because I thought that wouldn't, because I wanted to, some, I don't know, someone with, I don't know who was waxing what. I was like, oh, let me try that. And I put the wax and then put that little piece of cloth. Whew, that was not, I didn't like it. That hurt. Can't imagine doing that on a regular basis or. Yeah, but have you ever done that? There's like that cream.
Nair
or something like that. I've done that. I've tried that before, but that'll give you a better, closer, no hair. And it like goes down in there and like melts your hair or something. I don't know what it does.
It's so smelly.
It's smelly, but.
But yes, instead of having to shave or wax.
I probably wouldn't use that on your private areas, though.
No. I mean, if that's your thing, go for it. But
I'm not going to yuck your yum, but I would say
don't do it. No. So, yeah. So that brings us to grooming products.
Grooming products.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like, is there anything that you specifically use, like, for your beard or to make your hair silky soft?
I use beard oils. I've used a number of different brands for it. So I have a lot of different ones. I don't like an overly scented one because I have kind of, I don't like that much scent right by my face all day long. So I use that. And I use, like, it's called a boar's hair brush. So it's, like, really a stiff bristle brush to kind of brush your beard to keep it kind of cleaned up and tidy. Cause my hair is really coarse anyway. So my beard hair is even worse. So I try to, it's not like 100, I don't brush it every night before bed or anything, but just in the morning before I go to work or whatever.
Right.
That's the only thing I really use on my beard. I don't use any special shampoos or conditioners on my beard.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm the same way as far as beard oil goes there. I don't want something that has a lot of scents that smells very strong. Mm-hmm. And part of it is because most beard oils do not smell that great.
Like, no, they don't smell good.
No, they don't. They don't. So you don't want that on you. Yeah. So there was a company that will not be named, but they sent a bunch of their stuff to Chubster, and I tried one of their beard oils for about a week, and it was just, the smell was just, I just couldn't see how somebody could hang with that in their face constantly. So
I like a little bit of fragrance, but nothing. It's more like a cedar and woodsy kind of smell, I think, is the one I really like.
Yes.
I don't know if it's like, I don't remember what it's called, but I like that.
Those smells are good.
Yeah,
for sure.
As far as my like hair goes, I just use like a clay or like a pomade in my hair all the time just to keep it. I don't use a high shine one, but I think it's just like a paste of some kind.
I don't think
there's anything in it right now, but.
Well, see, you've got that full thick hair, so that works. Now I've got fine sad hair, and so what that means is that I can't use heavy product, and it's taken me a few decades to realize that. I used to use really, really strong, really stiff stuff to make it do what I wanted it to do. Mm-hmm. Then I started using pomades and clays, and all of that stuff was just too much for my hair. So what I realized is now I just use like a salt spray, and it's very easy on the hair. It's
you get a lot of texture doing that. I like that stuff too.
Yeah. Yeah, I did a photo shoot a couple years ago, and the hairstylist there was like, he was spraying it in my hair, and so I started talking to him about it, and he's like, this is what you should be using for your hair, and he was right. It's been great. So absolutely.
Yeah, I've used that stuff. It's nice. It adds a lot of body and texture. Kind of,
definitely.
Yeah, that's nice. And you can use your actual product after that, but it gives it a different feel. It's nice.
So I have a story about a hair related story that I want to all share, right. But before I jump into that, the last question I wanted to ask you is, do you have you ever gotten like a a bad haircut, or have you ever tried to trim hair and have it not go well, or done a beard trim that's gone awry? Yeah,
I mean, I've gotten bad haircuts multiple times. If you ever move or your stylist moves or something, you go to somewhere else. And my hair, like I said before, my hair is really thick and coarse, so it kind of doesn't do what normal hair does. So a lot of times they'll try to use the clippers and then go really quick on the sides, and it'll grab because it won't cut it, and they'll just like yank. And I'm like, okay, y'all need to slow down and take your time. Or they'll do like those thinning shears. I don't know. They're like weird scissors with like teeth in them or something. They have like little notches in them, and they go in and like try to take out a lot of the bulk, but it just is not right for my hair. I've gotten lots of weird. I got a perm one time, long time ago. My mom was a hairstylist, whatever. And my brother got a perm, and it looked really cool on his head. I got one, and I got like a weird kind of afro looking thing. It was not a good look, unfortunately.
I love it.
But you know, I love it. Like my mom always said, it'll grow out. So it's, you can color it, you can dye it, do whatever, weird cuts.
It's true. Yes. It'll, you do it, you do something wrong, you can wipe it off and start over, basically.
Yeah. You can shave it down
with a razor.
Yeah. You can shave it all down if you need to and start over. And yeah. I'm trying not to get into the quarantine craziness of like shaving my head or dyeing my hair or anything like that. But
yeah,
regular little trim it up was fine for me.
I think every few years I feel the need to shave my head. And I think a couple of years ago I did it, and then it was kind of the last time. And I think I shaved it, and I was like, I don't actually like this as much as I used to. So,
yeah,
you know, and it, generally when it's not pandemic time, the side of my head is shaved, and I kind of keep this off the top and go from there. But, yeah. You know, it's a whole new world right now. So
yeah,
you just kind of go with what you got.
That is one thing I'm more self-conscious about, is like shaving my head. Like I feel like I have a big head. I have like moles, I have moles all over, and I have them on my head too. So I just feel like self-conscious about that. So I don't know that I would, even if it's like really short, sometimes I don't like it.
Yeah.
So I don't know that hopefully I don't go completely bald, but I don't, if it happens, it happens, but.
Luckily I have the kind of head that you can do that with and feel pretty good about it. I think for that works. And also, considering my hair does not have volume, it's not that far away from being shaved.
I know. Down, like sometimes when your hair is like really short, it looks almost like you're bald. Mm-hmm. You know,
it does.
So it's like, I've never,
nothing
crazy like that for me.
All right. So I'll tell my story here. So again, this was back when I worked in radio, and we were doing a Christmas concert, and I was in radio, and I worked as a, I was on air on the morning show for this, at this radio station that I worked at. And I, did promotions, and I was also their stunt guy. So it was at the time that all that kind of stuff, you do dumb stunts, and they'd send people out there. So was like
shock jock, like the weird,
like kind of like Jackass,
like Jackass kind of stuff. Yeah.
But not as good, you know. Okay. not as hardcore in every case. So so we had this Christmas concert coming up, and somehow the idea came around for me to be Santa, but what they wanted to do was put me in liquid latex. And liquid latex is basically exactly that. It comes in a big jar. You can paint it on your body, and it comes right off if you don't have body hair.
Yeah.
So
it's kind of like those charcoal masks that people have been doing. You know, those weird masks that people are putting on and like trying to rip off.
Yep.
It's like that, but it's shinier and.
Yes. Yeah. And it's kind of rubbery latex, you know, when once it dries. And so, I, over the course of like 3 days, basically shaved my entire body. I had to have help with some things. We did this whole liquid latex thing. And I mean, Shaving your chest whenever you have a pretty hairy chest is such a weird thing. It was just the weirdest feeling to not like, I don't know. It was so weird, but everything from like my neck down was gone. And, they put the liquid latex on me.
How did they get it on you?
Yes. Oh. They painted it on me. They painted the liquid latex on me, put me in a thong and some combat boots and, like a Santa beard and a Santa cap and sent me out.
Where are the pictures of this?
You know what? I do have one picture. It's like, it's a picture. It's a picture from behind and it's me up on the stage. It's glorious. So nice. bright red liquid latex ass cheeks. And you know, wow. So, and so for the,
sure the
for
kids love that.
Yes. Yes. We've got that hanging on the mantle. It's, it's every beautiful. Christmas. Yes.
That, mommy.
Yes. That's Santa, kids.
That should be like Krumpus or something.
Totally. And when you're bad,
liquid latex Santa comes for you.
So it was good for about a week after, and then everything started to grow back out.
See, that's the horrible part. I can't handle that.
Oh, think about that all over your body. No. It was horrible. It was so bad. Oh man. So I learned a valuable lesson, and that valuable lesson was that I needed to get out of radio.
Yeah.
And
they put never a lot.
Yes. And never shave your body. Now the radio thing was fine. I just, don't shave your body.
Yeah.
Don't shave your body. So,
yeah.
Yeah.
Well, if you are into the, like, you want to be smooth, I would actually recommend that, like, Nair or cream.
Yeah.
Say the word, but it lasts longer than a shaving does. And when it grows back, it doesn't have like a sharp edge to it. So it's not quite as irritating. I've been reading up on this stuff. I've used it a couple times, but I don't like the smell of it. So
yeah. Yeah.
And you won't get quite the razor burn and stuff like that from shaving and whatnot.
That's really the trick is, yeah, don't shave your entire body because bad news.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well,
so
what do you have another thing of the week at all for this one?
You know, it feels like this week has flown by. Like, I think I don't know. I just felt like I was kind of off my game this week until really today. So I just kind of spent a lot of time with my family, with my kids, and my daughter learned how to ride her bike without training wheels. So that is, yes. And, you know, it was funny because I was thinking, you know, we started out with me like going with her and walking her along and holding her and stuff. And she finally just got to a point where she was like, no, I'm going to do this on my own. And so she went out and she would start to balance and she just got it. She got it herself on the second day and just took off and she loves it. So, yeah, that's her thing of the week, but I'm going to claim it.
Well, yeah, you were there helping before that. Yeah.
That's right. Cool.
I guess my thing of the week is that we're getting ready to launch a new product and a new jock strap. So we have a new jock strap coming out in May. So
nice.
This is coming out in May. So it'll be out. So we're getting ready to launch that. So just, you know, getting the website, making sure the photos are ready, getting the ads ready, getting the emails, all that kind of stuff ready to go. So check out bearskin.com for all the new stuff that we got coming out. So we got some new stuff for the summer and I'm kind of excited about it and trying to finalize the next order too. So that's been kind of get all the prints and figure out what we're doing for the next one and like doing some, you know, like analyzing what's selling well and what people are asking for. And it's always like, oh, are people going to still buy this or do they really want more of this or, you know, so.
Yeah. Right.
Playing that game and figuring some stuff out. And I'm excited for the direction that we're heading. So
awesome.
Do some more stuff and I don't know. Right. Yeah, I'm excited.
Well, keep our eyes peeled.
Yeah.
All the new stuff.
Yeah. We'll have plenty of new stuff. So.
Yes. All right.
Well, thanks, Bruce.
We've said everything that we can say about hair. Today,
yeah. So. For now, for this one, we might talk about it again, but Got you some advice. We'll have some links to some of these products that we use or recommend. Maybe we'll find that Santa photo and share that. Maybe not.
Maybe. I did just remember that I was lighting a cigarette for someone over the stove, and I burnt my hairline right off. So I remember lighting the cigarette.
You just light all the hair on fire and that'll take care of it.
And burnt hair just has a horrible smell. And so I was lighting the cigarette for somebody and I was like, what is that smell? And sure enough, it was me.
Or so. The grill does that too. I've done that a couple of times.
When you light the grill,
and it like, yep, all your hair is gone. That's fun.
Yep. All right.
Well, on that note, thanks everybody. Make sure you share this episode with all your hairy friends so they can get some tips on how to do some hair removal.
Yes. And
send us some pictures if you have home haircuts. I want to see
it. Please
tag us at Heavy Convo and your Instagram pics and send us some pictures.
Yes, indeed. Show us your pictures, please. I need to see this. Right.
Thanks, Bruce.
Bye, Jody.
Bye.
Thanks for listening to Heavy Conversation. Be sure to like and subscribe on iTunes or wherever you get your podcast.